Why are you helping me?
Unlike Sokolov, the thought of defecting has never once crossed my mind. I love my country. I love this land. I cannot even imagine living anywhere else. I wish to remain a hero of the great motherland. I cannot bear the thought of being hounded into a corner and left to waste away. It is already dawn. You must hurry. I will remain here and nurse my troubles for a little longer. To capitalism!
Okay. See if I have any better luck leaving the door open. Okay, cool. I've been looking for one of those for a while. Will this guy see me? What are you doing? Stop looking. Oh, come on. Why would this guy, like, hear that? That's a bullshit alert system. I think this is the only area in the game where it's kind of like that. It's kind of bullshitty, but... gotta deal with it. I guess I should. I don't know, maybe I can just keep using this for now. No. This is one cheap way to get out. I think there's a uniform hidden in here. It's either a uniform or a face camo. Oyama? Wonder what that looks like. See, that's the sort of thing you don't want to be wearing. Doing a dramatic cutscene. But you might end up putting it on because it might be the best camo for you to use during a certain area. And then you end up triggering a cutscene and kind of ruins it. That would probably be really effective during the final boss fight. Because of course it takes place in that white field. But then you would ruin the really dramatic cutscene straight after. Do I ever use claymores? Don't think I do. Okay, 70%. That's decent. Yeah, they're coming.
What's wrong?
I hate doing that. It's just, it feels really cheap. I I'm only using the tranquilizer gun when I end up in a situation like that. Otherwise, I would prefer not to use it, of course. The suppressors will spawn, eh? So I could keep going back to that building to get another suppressor, if I was that desperate. Let's just get to one of the worst boss fights. Well, it's not a boss fight. In terms of gameplay, it's just mediocre. It's just the character that I hate. As opposed to the pain where it wasn't just the gameplay, it was the character. Like, with the pain, I hated the character and the gameplay during the boss fight. But with this boss fight coming up, it's mainly just the character. I think the gameplay is just mediocre. I'm not 100% sure how it works, but your health bar does increase over time with when you get injured. So it's as if your body is healing itself and getting stronger. So your life bar is gradually getting bigger as you play the game. Before I leave, I don't have a scope, never mind. I wanted to see what was on that poster. If I had the scope equipped, I would, but I can't be bothered to get it out of my inventory. I don't want to go through another menu, you know, so. Here we go.
Brazilian wandering spider. Soon a most exquisite pain will engulf your entire body. Your limbs will be paralyzed, your lungs cease to draw breath. Eventually your heart will stop beating. Ah, but what fun would that be? Not a fitting end at all. The boss's apprentice. I will give you fear such as you've never experienced before. Come into my web. It is time for you to feel the fear.
I mean, what personality does this guy have? Aside from the fact he keeps repeating his own name over and over again. It's just, like, who is this guy? What is his story? It's just lame. His abilities, I don't know, he just seems very flexible, I guess. He can run on water. He can turn invisible. Aside from that, I mean, I don't get it. And the thing is, it's not as if the bosses have to have cool abilities, because Revolver Ocelot is just a normal guy who is really good with a revolver. But his fight is a lot more interesting because, you know, as a character, he is interesting. But this guy, the Fear, he's basically some asshole who just keeps repeating his name over and over again. I mean, he's just really lame. Let's see what everyone has to say.
The Fear is using something called stealth camouflage to conceal himself. But you should be able to spot him if you look closely in first-person view. Watch for rustling grass, falling leaves, anything that will betray his presence. Find him and shoot him in first-person view. Snake, watch out for the Fear's poison bolts.
If you're hit with a poison bolt, the poison will enter your bloodstream. Unless you neutralize it with serum, your life will just keep diminishing. If you're hit by a poison bolt, go into the survival viewer immediately and use Cure to give yourself a serum injection. You can get serum by capturing the rabbits that live in that area. After you neutralize the
rabbits, give Sue.
Don't forget to treat the wound itself, too. To treat a bolt wound, you'll need your knife, a styptic, and a disinfectant. Use your knife to dig out the bolt, and then apply styptic and disinfectant to the wound. Follow those steps, and the wound should heal right up.
Snake, the fear is supposed to be wearing some kind of stealth
camera. It bends lights around them.
I don't know how it works exactly, but it seems to refract the light around it somehow to hide the person who's wearing it. This is the best camouflage I've ever seen. It's going to be tough to figure out where he is. But that doesn't mean he doesn't have a weak point. Apparently, wearing stealth camo really drains your stamina. When he's out of stamina, the camo will stop working. Don't miss your opportunity.
Okay. Now, this fight can be over in a few seconds. Well, not a few seconds, but you can end it pretty quickly. You don't even have to move to win. For example, as long as you just keep blocking, you can stay in this exact same spot. As long as you just keep following him, you can just kill him this way. You don't even need the thermal goggles. You can just keep following him. Half of his health is already down. The thing is, it kind of spoils the fun of the fight if you keep doing that, so I try not to. I do try and run around, because this area is of course littered with a bunch of traps. And that's supposed to be the fun of the fight. You're running around trying to kill him, but at the same time, you're running into, like, avoiding traps at the same time. That's supposed to be the fun of the fight. But like I was demonstrating just then, you can just stand in the same spot that you start. You don't even have to move, and you can just win that way. But as I said, this spoils the fun of the fight, so I'm just going to move around a little bit. Having said that, I'm probably going to end the fight immediately. Of course, he does heal himself if you're going for the non-lethal kill. And thermal goggles. Again, I don't really use thermal goggles. I think they spoil the fun of the fight. I mean, if you do that, like, what's the point? There's somebody by here. I am aware that if you throw down rotten food, he will... I'm not sure how exactly it works. I've heard that if you throw rotten food, he'll come down and eat it. And that'll give you, like, a chance to attack him. And of course, when he eats the rotten food, I would imagine that does a little bit of damage to his stamina. I've never tried it, but I've always heard about it. Okay, I'm just going to kill him now. I'm just going to... properly try and kill him. If I can find him. Oh, he just ate more food. Where is he? I don't see him. I keep using that... the kit on accident. Okay, yeah. I think I got my... Nope, I lost them.
Dodge this.
Missed. But we run out of ammo. Oh, great. I'm saying, like, he doesn't really have a personality, and the game never explains his story or anything like that. I'm sure that somebody, some diehard fan, is going to say, well, actually, they do explain his story in this novelization or something like that. But it's never explained within the game. Or if it is in the game, it must be hidden somewhere in some, like, optional codec conversation that you would have to call them a million times to hear. I was doing pretty well there until I ran out of ammo. That's kind of screwed me over. Wait, is there any ammo? I can't find any. I just want some tranquilizers. Had to be a claymore. I saw the wire, I was just hoping it would be one of those swinging things. Okay, there's no playing around, let's just do it.
You'll die if you...
Get off the screen! Stop calling me.
Now, here.
It's on his last legs. And that's how you do it.
The fear! The fear! I see it! The fear!
Well, at least the two worst boss fights in the series are over with. And as you just saw there, of course he blows up. Like, every single member of the Cobra unit blows up when you kill them. And it's kind of unnecessary, really over-dramatic, and I never understood why they did it until I triggered an optional codec conversation. I think you can trigger it by here, actually. I think you have to call Sigint a couple number of times.
There seem to be traps planted throughout that...
Just tell me about the traps, whatever.
Pit traps and snares are camouflaged.
Sigint, Granin said something about putting legs on a tank. Do you know what he was talking about?
If you ask me, it's gotta be a joke. Not only is making a tank walk on two legs a technical nightmare, but there's no point in making a walking tank to begin with. Putting legs on a tank would raise its clearance, increasing its frontal projection area. It'd also be less stable. Suppose the legs help the tank travel on bad roads. I don't see the logic in that. Isn't that what treads are for? I mean, anybody who'd seriously consider making a thing like that has got to be a wacko. Come to think of it, there was a guy in the States who wrote a paper on that subject. What was his name? Emerson? Heinrich? Something like that. I don't really remember. Of course, no one took that seriously.
Sigint. Granin was saying that Sokolov's research project was a tank fitted with rockets.
Uh-huh.
Do you have any idea what he meant?
Sorry, beats me. I wonder if it's supposed to increase the tank's mobility, or maybe give the tank short-range missile-launching capability. But you're sure it has something to do with Phase 2 of the Shagohod, right?
Yeah.
Khrushchev traded Cuba just to get this thing finished, and Volgin blew up a Soviet research facility to get his hands on it. Whatever it is, it's gotta be big. Pit traps and...
Sigint, do you know anything about that philosopher's legacy Granin was talking about?
Not a clue. Never even heard of something like that until now.
Right.
One thing's for sure, though. Vogan's got a huge amount of money stashed away somewhere. philosopher's legacy, huh? Maybe it is real. That Order of Lenin that Granin was talking about is the most prestigious award in the Soviet Union. It's given to individuals, organizations, and cities for outstanding achievements in warfare, science, industry, the arts, and various other fields. You could say it's the highest honor the East has to give.
It's a lot of interesting optional information. I haven't even heard half this stuff.
You say Granin was involved in the development of the SS-1C. The SS-1C is the Soviets' newest short-range tactical ballistic missile. Based on what Western intel has been able to gather, it's capable of being launched from a mobile platform.
A mobile platform?
Yeah. It's a transport vehicle that functions as an erector and a launcher. It can travel on roads, then erect and launch a missile from any location. Of course, in addition to conventional explosives, the missiles could also be fitted with chemical or even nuclear warheads.
A nuclear missile that can be launched from any location.
I'll bet it wasn't the missile itself that Granin helped develop. More likely, it was the mobile platform. From what I've heard, the SS-1C is set for actual deployment as early as next year. That's bound to send a chill down NATO's spine. If you do set off a... Clapper...
Maybe he tells you about it later.
The weapon you've got equipped now...
But basically, every member of the Cobra unit blows up when they die, and they do explain why they do that.
According to Granin, you should be able to get to the mountains through a passage located deep in the jungle beyond the warehouse.
Right. Then if I climb the mountains, there'll be an underground tunnel leading to Groznygrad near the summit.
Start out by going back to the warehouse. Use the key you got from Granin to open the door and proceed into the jungle. You remember where the door is,
don't you? Of course.
According to Granin...
Major, why do they keep exploding?
It's part of their legend.
Legend?
The legend of the Cobra unit. I'll let Sigint explain. Sigint?
Yeah, that. That's a microbomb.
A microbomb?
Yep. During World War II, the Cobra unit was used for the nastiest kinds of wet works, the kind that could never be let out into the open. Their missions were so top secret that not only were they forbidden to be taken prisoner, they couldn't even leave their corpse behind. Because of this, or so the legend goes, they carried a microbomb with them on their missions in case they needed to commit suicide. I always thought it was just a rumor. I never expected it would turn out to be true. But why would they be carrying bombs this time around? It's not like they're in hostile territory.
Maybe they're ready to die.
Ready to die?
Yeah. They've got no unit to go back to. Not even a country.
So they've got no place to die except the battlefield, huh?
Yeah. No turning back for them. I wonder if the boss feels the same.
It's really sad when you think about it that way. Uniform Spider, of course, if you whenever you kill a member of the Cobra unit non-lethally, they drop. Uniform. I didn't bother collecting the Pain's uniform, even though I killed him non-lethally, but yeah. That spider uniform actually gives you really good camo, but it drains your stamina incredibly fast, so it's kind of a double-edged sword. That's what people say, right? I'm assuming if I eat that poison dart frog, it will actually poison me, so I'll pass on that. Alright, we got one guy down here, and who am I kidding? I'm gonna get spotted. I knew it, I knew it.
Radio, get us some backup!
Screw you guys. Oh, I didn't want to roll off. Yeah, wait for me. Like I said, I'm not good at MGS3. Give me a break. Should we get a codec from Eva? Eva? Yeah.
Snake, are you there?
Eva, where are you?
In the fortress, in Groznygrad. Dr. Sokolov is here too.
Is he all right?
He's fine. Right now he's busy putting the finishing touches on the Shagohod.
Good. That means they haven't killed him.
Not yet, anyway, but you better hurry. They've already finished the Phase 2 tests. Once the final preparations are complete, they'll have no more use for him. The Colonel won't have any qualms about killing him if he thinks the CIA is closing in.
Eva, you can't let Sokolov out of your sight.
I know. Snake, do you know where Groznygrad is?
Granin told me that I should be able to get there from the mountains to the north, through an underground tunnel.
Granin told you?
Yeah. He even gave me the key to the warehouse.
Why?
Because he was drunk, I guess.
You've got to be kidding me.
Hell if I know.
Snake, there's one problem with that route.
What problem?
The mountain entrance to the underground tunnel that leads to the fortress is sealed. You need a key to get in.
A key? What about the key Granin gave me?
That key won't work. But don't worry, I'll figure something out. I have an idea. There are some ruins at the top of the mountains. Meet me there.
The top of the mountains. Got it.
Wait. There's something else I've got to tell you.
Now what?
The end.
I heard that one of the Cobras is waiting for you in the jungle at the foot of the mountains. He's a legendary sniper called The End.
Yeah, I've seen him before. That ridiculously old guy, right?
Don't underestimate him. He's known as the father of modern sniping.
Is he alone? No spotter?
None. He's all by himself. Apparently, he doesn't need a spotter.
You can't be serious.
The entire forest is on his side.
The forest?
Stay alert.
Yeah. I'd hate to have it be the end for me.
I've always noticed that there's a lot of healing items you can grab around here. If you equip the thermal goggles, it allows you to see all these plants that you can destroy, which of course give you various items, such as the splint. And I used quite a bit of them earlier, so yeah, I do really need these. Handgun? Okay, not sure what that is. Some weapon, I guess. There doesn't seem to be much areas in the game where you can actually grab these medical items. There's a room on the top of the mountain which is filled with healing items which you can grab. And then there's this little area by here, but those are really the only two areas that I can recall off the top of my head. Aside from that, you're pretty much on your own from what I can tell. I wonder what would happen if you used up all of your medical supplies early on in the game. I mean, how would you get through the game from that point on? I know if when you're injured, you save the game and come back a little bit later, all of your injuries are healed, so maybe you would have to keep doing that. But I would imagine the game has a way to, like, supplement. It has a way to save you in case you do run out of healing items, I would imagine. Kojima seems like the sort of guy who would think of a way to, you know, remedy those kind of situations. Okay, at that point I think I'm gonna give it a little break. I didn't have much time to record today, so I'll leave it at that.
Saving a game, Snake?
I do like these conversations that a paramedic has with Snake every time you save the game.
Snake? Have you seen 007 from Russia with Love?
Nah, I don't like those movies. Real spies are nothing like James Bond. It's pure fantasy.
Snake, I don't think the Major's going to like you saying that.
And even though it's fiction, I can't help but comparing myself to Bond.
What exactly don't you like about James Bond? I mean, is it the fantastic gadgets? The cars? The guns?
Major.
Snake, wouldn't you like to have a gun shaped like a pen?
What good is a pen gonna do me in the jungle? I'd look like a fool.
Then what about a snake-shaped gun? You could make it look like you're grappling with a giant snake and then get a shot in on the enemy while they're distracted.
Okay, now you're being ridiculous.
We'll make you a snake-shaped gun that folds up and fits into an attaché case.
Will you give it a rest?
Oh, I get it. You're worried about how to handle the ladies, aren't you?
No.
I knew it. To tell you the truth, I don't like the idea of playing hanky-panky with enemy femme fatales either. But that's part of Bond's appeal. You could learn a thing or two from him. I mean, what about this Eva? What are you planning to do with her?
I don't even trust her yet.
No, that's not what I mean. You can't let yourself get involved. This is a game of spy versus spy. She's using you just as much as you're using her.
I realize that.
You've got to grab the initiative, and to do that, you have to get the upper hand in the relationship. That's what a spy is supposed to do.
Get the upper hand? I don't think I'm cut out for that mission.
Maybe if you change your code name to 00 Snake.
Hejar.
007 is the biggest thing to come out of England since the Mayflower. I wouldn't be surprised if they made 20 more of those movies.
Didn't you know? The Major is a huge James Bond fan. Don't get him worked up like this.
Worked up?
Maybe you don't realize this, but now that you've got him started talking about Bond, I'm going to have to listen to him lecture for a whole hour after he gets off the radio.
You have my sympathy.
It's too bad you can't enjoy such a great movie, though.
I guess I'm just one of those people who can't enjoy spy flicks.
Major Zero, it's kind of like Paramedic. They both seem pretty nice and so innocent in this game, from what you see of them in this game, at least. And then later on, you find out what they did after MGS3, and you're like, "What, really? That's what the characters became after this game." And they both seem so innocent and nice, especially after that codec conversation. Major Zero just seems like such a goofball. So when you find out what he ends up doing, you're like, "Really?" I mean, I always found that really, really weird. But of course, the Phantom Pain is going to elaborate on Major Zero, what he did after this game. So, it's cool that we're going to get to see we've only heard what he was like after MGS3. We've never got to see him, what he was like after MGS3. So it's cool that we're finally going to get to see him in his glory, you know, in the Phantom Pain. Okay, so I'm done for now. Okay, so I'm back, and I'm kind of annoyed because I just recorded myself. I just recorded getting to the final boss, well, yesterday. And then when I tried to edit the footage today, I discovered that the files were corrupted. So my capture card is playing up, unfortunately. And that means I have to record this all over again. So I recently just recorded me beating the game yesterday. Or at least getting to the final boss yesterday. And it turns out all of that footage is no good, and now I'm going to have to do it all over again. Which is kind of annoying, but, you know, whatever. Okay, I was wondering who that was. Some guy right in front of me.
Huh?
Wow.
The enemy.
And I'm sucking really bad. That was terrible. I actually did quite well when I was sneaking through this area yesterday. I managed to get past it without getting spotted. Not that it's hard or anything, but you know, it's nice that I was able to. Of course, we got the end boss fight coming up in a moment. A lot of people love that fight, like as in most people say it's their favourite fight in the series. If not one of their favourites, at least. I can run for it. Wait. Yeah, okay. I feel strange kind of recording this after already recording it yesterday. Because when I'm thinking of stuff to say, I'm trying to think in my head, did I already say that yesterday? Or have I already said it today? So I'm getting a little bit confused there. In case I didn't make any earlier save files as well, I had to get to this point of the game all over again. Not that it took long, it took an hour. I mean, it's a pretty short game when you're skipping the cutscenes, which was obviously what I was doing when I was getting up to this point again.
Huh? What? Who's that?
I think the sound of you standing up makes a sound. Because that dude like spun around. So I guess the sound of you standing up is enough to alert them. I don't think it should, but whatever.
beg of you. Grant me the strength to take this final prey. Let me linger in this world. Just...
I don't think there's any nanomachines going on there. That's just pure supernatural.
I have already slept enough for one lifetime. Enough for an eternity.
And that's the way I prefer it. Like, I hated when they explained Vamp with nanomachines in the last game, while in MGS4.
I have to thank you for waking.
And of course, in MGS4, they explained how Screaming Mantis, for those of you who don't know, in MGS4 is a character who can control people, psychic. A lot like Psycho Mantis. But in the MGS1, Psycho Mantis was just supernatural, they never explained it. He was just some psychic guy. And in MGS4, they explained Screaming Mantis by saying she can control people using their nanomachines. And it's just like, there's no need. Just, you know, keep it supernatural.
I am the end. I am here to send you to your ultimate fate. You'll make a fine quarry for my final hunt.
I found that sniper you were talking about.
That's the end. He's a legend, known as the father of sniping.
I've got experience sniping in urban and marine environments.
What about the forest?
Never.
I see. Well, that forest is divided into three areas, a river, a plateau, and a clearing. He should be lying in wait for you in one of those places.
Sounds like this may take a while.
It'll be a test of endurance. Be careful, though. From what I've heard, the End has an almost supernatural knack for camouflaging himself.
So, whoever moves first loses. This guy's over 100 years old, though, so I should have the advantage in terms of stamina.
I wouldn't be so sure if I were you.
Why's that?
I've heard that his body is photosynthetic, like a plant.
What is he, some kind of monster?
On top of that, he can speak to the forest, too.
So in other words, he knows it inside out.
Uh-huh. But he doesn't know you. I'm sure you can beat him.
Don't worry. I intend to.
Okay, so obviously this boss fight is basically a sniper duel, and it can last a very long time. Well, on your first playthrough account, well, it's really a fight which will last as long as you want it to. Because obviously you can get really immersed into it and just crawl around trying to be stealthy, trying to hunt him down. Alternatively, you could just run around until he sees you, and then he'll try to shoot at you, then you just shoot back at him, and you can basically end the fight in about 5 minutes if you do that. Or you can just go up behind him and keep following him and keep shooting him and following him, and then the fight will be over in 5 minutes. So this fight kind of lasts as long as you want it to. In this case, because I just beat the game yesterday and the recording messed up, I kind of just want to end this as soon as possible, so I'm gonna use cheap tactics. He always starts off in that exact same spot, so when you replay the game, you can, you know, get a shot at him immediately. Like, I do like this fight, but it's one of those things I need to have time for, or one of those things I need to be in the mood for, because this fight can last, like I said, as long as you want to. It can last multiple hours. Right now, of course, I just want to kind of just get through it as quick as possible, because I'm recording. And not only am I recording, I'm recording for the second time. Because, of course, I lost the footage from yesterday, so, you know. You can't blame me for just wanting to rush through this. And the boss fight is unique in the sense that it spans three different areas as well. It's not just limited to one room or one field, like every other boss fight in the series. It's actually, like, three different areas. If you sneak up behind him and hold him up three times in a row, you do actually, he drops a camo. See, this is my tactic, because I'm just rushing for it. I'm not sure where he is. I mean, he's shooting at me, but I assumed he would be up here. Oh, I saw him. He's running away. Alright, so for those of you who haven't played the game, you might be thinking, oh, what a lame fight. But, I'm kind of ruining the fight here, because like I said, I'm trying to rush through it. But yeah, this fight can be one of the better ones in the series. It's like I said, it's one of those things you can really get immersed into. Sneaking through the jungle, having a one-on-one sniper duel. And the Phantom Pain, of course there's going to be a boss fight with Quiet in the Phantom Pain as well. For those of you who don't know, Quiet is a character in the Phantom Pain who is basically a sniper as well. That should be a lot of fun. I'm looking forward to that. Because apparently the boss fight with her takes place in an open world, so that should be really cool. I'm going to try and sneak up behind him now. I'm assuming he's in the grass, one of these patches. Ah, he's on the left. There's a lot of cool different tricks with this fight. You can capture his parrot, and then when you release it, it'll fly back to him, which basically gives away his location.
Freeze.
Here we go, got him held up. If you do this 3 times, then he will drop a camo. Maybe not. Maybe you just hold him up once.
I don't think so.
Just gotta aim at his head.
Fine.
Yeah, there it is. I'll grab it in a moment.
Try this on for size.
And this is what I mean by, you know, you can just cheese it. Just keep shooting at him and chasing him like this. I mean, he does drop a flashbang every time you shoot him a few times, which is, you know, supposed to give him the opportunity to escape, but you can normally see him running away anyway, so you can just follow him. Now, like I said, if I was not recording this for the second time, I would be taking my time and being stealthy and, getting immersed into it, but I just want to go through this. Another cool thing, which I think pretty much everyone knows, is that if you're looking through the scope of your sniper rifle and you take too long, the end can sneak up behind you. He'll hold you up, but instead of killing you, he'll knock you out, and then you'll wake up in prison, back where you talked to Granin. So then you'll have to backtrack from that building to get back to the boss fight. When that happened to me when I was a kid, that scared the hell out of me. Of course, you can use thermal goggles to give away his location, but that just... Is that him? Oh, wow. I didn't actually see him there. But the thing is, if you use thermal goggles, it spoils the fun of the fight, so, you know, it's like, if you do that, what's the point? Unless you're rushing through it like I am, but I'm still not using them. Another cool thing is that, again, this is one of those things that everybody knows, everyone who has played the game knows, but just in case you somehow haven't heard of this trick, if you save the game and then come back after about a week or a few days, you'll find that the end has died of old age and you won't have to fight him. One of those classic Kojima tricks. Although I'm giving Kojima all the credit. We don't know if Kojima was the one who came up with that. Might have been. Because, you know, there is, of course, a team of people working on these games. So we do tend to give Kojima all of the credit when I'm sure he didn't do everything, obviously. Oh, it's a rabbit. Might be in that grassy patch up there. Although you normally see the lens flare off his rifle, so I'm guessing maybe not. Nope. Oh, okay. Yeah, I see him. Got him. He's dead. Oh. That's it. Like I said, the boss fight is really cool. It's just I'm rushing it. I do like it, and I do normally take my time.
Spirits of the forest, I thank you. The boss would be proud of you.
Out of every member of the Cobra unit except for the boss, I think the End has the best death scene.
I've been wandering for more than a century, and now my journey comes to a close. What a splendid way to end it all. I have no regrets. I can return to the Forum Arla.
Purely for the teeth. That's why that's the best death scene. So, of course, earlier on in the game, you could have killed the End before you got to this fight. Hang on, just gonna fill up Snake's belly. Okay. So, earlier on in the game, of course, you can kill the End with a sniper rifle after a cutscene if you're fast enough. And so you kill him there, it saves you having to fight him here. Because, of course, this fight can last a while, so Kojima decided to put in these different ways you can end the fight immediately. In case some people are having trouble with it. So if you end up killing the End earlier on, when you reach this area, instead of the boss fight, it's just filled with soldiers from Ocelot's unit. And that's it. I mean, you don't have to kill them. You can just sneak past them if you want. It's up to you what you want to do. But instead of fighting the End, you just have to deal with a bunch of normal soldiers. I'm trying to figure out where to go. I guess I should just check the map. Okay. I really hope the Phantom Pain has a lot of great boss fights, because the previous Metal Gear game, which was Peace Walker, had some... Well, we all know how that turned out. Peace Walker just... The boss fights in Peace Walker were terrible. I kind of liked Zeke at the end. But aside from Zeke, the rest were just really lame. I just didn't like him at all. If you haven't played Peace Walker, the boss fights in Peace Walker are just robots, like mechs. They are basically Metal Gears. That's every single boss fight in Peace Walker. And they are essentially bullet sponges, and they aren't fun. They're just really tedious and repetitive to fight. But from what I understand, the Phantom Pain will have, you know, normal human boss fights, which is what we want. I'm sure it'll have one or two mechs. Like, in the trailer you can see Liquid piloting Metal Gear Rex, or a prototype of Rex. So I'm sure you'll fight like Rex or one or two robots like that. But for the most part, it looks like it's going to be human characters. Like, you know, Volgin is coming back, you got Psycho Mantis. I mean, they wouldn't put Psycho Mantis in the game if we weren't going to fight him, right? That would be a missed opportunity. And this bit is just a really long ladder. You got the amazing Snake Eater theme song playing in the background. It's just such a weird and simple moment, but it's one of the more memorable moments in the whole entire series. That's the thing with Metal Gear, you never know what you're going to do next. I mean, we just had a boss fight with a 200-year-old dude, sniper, and now we're just climbing up a 3-minute ladder. And that's it. I think this is one of the few times where you should use the original camera. I don't know, that shot is a lot better than just this. If you're using the rotatable camera, you'll just be looking at this. Oh, well, you could rotate it downwards, which looks fine. Should we get the rat? Why not? Okay, so going on to like why I like the ends while I hate the pain and the fear. Like I said, the pain, I think the gameplay during the fight is just really lame. I find it really tedious. The fear is kind of just mediocre, but both suck in terms of characters, I think, because, I don't know, they're not really well defined. Or they don't seem as if they have a story behind them, or at least from what I've seen or heard. As opposed to the end, again, his story is really simple, but it's still something that you can understand and you can pick up on. I mean, he's just this old dude who... He's saving what little life he has left in him for this one crazy sniper duel with Snake. And so that's really it. That's the character. He's just this old dude who's about to die of old age. And he spends all of his time sleeping because he's waiting for a really exciting battle. That's how he wants to die. That's how he wants his life to end. And, it's simple and that's really it to the character. Or at least from what I can gather from the character, that's really it. But... It may be simple, but it's still something, and it's still kind of cool as well, even though it's really simple. And then you got the pain and the fear. Like, the pain is just a guy who can control bees. And then the fear, as I said before, they don't really define his abilities very well. He's just some guy who's really agile. He can turn invisible, and that's really it. And I feel the same way about the Fury. Like, I'll talk more about him when we fight him. But with the Fury, like, he may have like really little backstory, but from what I could piece together from his backstory, it is pretty interesting. And the fight itself is great as well. The Fury is actually one of my favourite boss fights in the series. Now, of course, later on in the game, there's a segment where every single soldier you've ever killed appears as a ghost throughout the game. So if you didn't kill a single person throughout the game, there will be no ghosts during the segment. For those of you who play the game, you know what I'm talking about. Now, if you kill a guard in this area, a vulture will begin to feast on his body. If you then kill that vulture and then eat the vulture, later on when the ghosts appear, there'll be a guard with a vulture on him, eating him, like eating the ghost. So it's one of those like cool little details, which only a few people will notice. I can normally sneak through this bit without getting spotted. This mountaintop is divided into three different areas. I can normally sneak past the first area without getting spotted, but I almost always get spotted on the second area. I say almost always, I've actually never once gotten past the second area without getting spotted. Not a single time. I can get like halfway through it, but then that's where I normally get spotted by someone. And then of course the alert phase carries over to the third area. Although I have been able to get past the third area without getting spotted before. That was actually yesterday when I lost all the footage. I think I can run, you can't hear me, right? It's all good. Okay, so not only do you have to deal with the foot soldiers on this segment, there's also a helicopter flying back and forth all the time. And if you destroy the helicopter, because earlier on in the game there was a parked helicopter, if you destroyed that using explosives, the helicopter would not appear on this mountain. It's one of those, you know, awesome Metal Gear touches. But instead of the helicopter, if you destroy the helicopter earlier, instead of having to deal with the helicopter, it would be a bunch of normal foot soldiers on these, you know, those hoverboards, wherever they are. I don't know what they're called. You know, those flying little hover things, wherever they are. There's a poisonous snake in here which normally bites me, so I'm going to get rid of him right now. Most of the time when I go through this game, I'm waiting in this cave for the helicopter to fly over. And then while I'm waiting, the snake normally gets me. Not today. Let's go wait for that helicopter. I think it's passing. The one good thing is I should be playing quite well today since, you know, of course I just played the game yesterday, so the locations of all the guards is fresh in my memory. There's a guard, yeah. That's who I was waiting for, this guy. I am aware there's a little hole by there I can sneak through, but I'm hoping I can CQC this guy. Okay, this is the perfect time for him to spin around while the helicopter is gone. Yeah. Oh, he walks faster than the speed you have to walk at for him not to hear you. I'll just tranquilize him. As I always say, I do think the tranquilizer spoils a lot of the fun. But with this guy, I'm gonna use it. Well, I might be able to catch up. Just don't turn around. Nice. Okay, that helicopter's coming back. It's over. It's all over. What? The alert phase just ended. The helicopter seemed to know where I was. I mean, it was shooting at me. Now, this is where I got spotted yesterday. I managed to sneak up to this point and then these guys spotted me. Mostly because I was trying to CQC them. But if I just trank them, I'm sure I can get by. Yeah. I had one of those rations. I don't think Snake likes the taste of them, if I remember right. Oh, that might have been Eva. I can't remember. Oh, whoa. Didn't realize there was a third guy. I don't think that alert phase is going to carry over since it was just that one guy left. He didn't have time to call her in, so I should be good. Oh, no, they are running. What can I do at this point, you know? Ooh. Hello. Please give me a little bit of leeway, because I just recorded this yesterday, like I said, and I have to do it all over again, so I'm kind of just like, eh, whatever. I did actually manage to sneak through this last area without getting spotted, though. The alert phase carried over from the second area yesterday, and then I ended up dying in this area. And then, of course, you know, the alert phase ends when you die, so there you go. Okay, so we can't go through here and trigger the cutscene until the alert phase ends, although it's about to. Until the evasion phase ends. The guards never seem to come up here, though. Unless one was, like, directly pursuing you right behind you.